Hi guys, this is Rohit Shah from Getting You Rich, and welcome to our analysis of Budget 2019 that was presented today. As you can see, government has got a lot of focus on startups, Digital India, Make in India initiative, social enterprises, NBFCs, housing finance companies, and a couple of great economic initiatives. This video is all about the 9 changes that we observed on the personal finance side, how the budget 2019 impacts your money, my money. So let's get started. The first change, we saw that the PAN and Aadhaar are proposed to be interlinked, which means that you can use Aadhaar card wherever the PAN is required. This is great news and would simplify our financial life. Now, they're also talking about e-assessment, that is the discussions when your return goes into a scrutiny can be done in an electronic faceless manner. While this has been discussed for a while now, the finance minister has proposed that this will be introduced in a phase-wise manner starting this year. Another interesting change that income tax would bring in is that your returns will be pre-filled with your income and gain information from salary, mutual fund transactions, bank interest, and these will be populated directly from the sources. So this should simplify preparing the income tax return for you. Another change is about the affordable housing category. If you're buying a house up to 45 lakh in this category, and if you buy it before 31st March 2020, you can get an additional benefit on the interest that you get, additional tax benefit on the interest you pay for 1.5 lakh. Taking the total deduction up to 3.5 lakhs. Similarly, if you're taking a loan for the electric vehicles, and if you take that loan before 31st March 2023, there is an additional tax benefit of 1.5 lakhs. Now, the government has realized that the rental laws in the country are very outdated, and they want to encourage the rental housing. So the proposal is to reform the rental laws. Similarly, National Housing Bank is regulating the housing finance companies, and they want to bring in more transparency, and now the housing finance companies will be regulated by RBI. To promote digital payments, the large enterprises with turnover of more than 50 crores would now be facilitating digital payments to you at no extra cost, nor to you nor to the merchant. The government disinvestment programs have been going very well, so the likes of CPSE ETFs will now be available for you to subscribe, like in ELSS fashion, which means you can get the Section ADC benefits. So these are the changes that we observed today's budget, and we hope that these will go in a long way to help you. That's all for today. Thank you. Bye-bye.